In this video, we're going to dig into 15 AP Biology tips that you can use today to start scoring those 4s or 5s on your AP exam. We'll start with some at-home tips, then move into multiple choice tips before wrapping up with some free response tips. So let's get into it. Starting with some at-home tips, the first tip for you is to make sure that you're staying consistent in your studying schedule. It's important that you devote time every single day or regularly throughout the week towards your AP Biology studies. If you don't do this, you're gonna end up cramming the night before the exam, and that's gonna lead to extra stress for you that's potentially gonna impact the way that you take your actual exam. The second thing that can be helpful is using an app like Quizlet for reviewing key terms. It's really important for you to understand key concepts that are commonly tested in AP Biology. So to do so, we recommend using an app like Quizlet in which you can load up a ton of flashcards and review some key concepts that you learned in class on the go. This sort of in-between time could be when you are traveling towards something, when you're preparing for bed, or some other time slot in which you just have a few extra minutes to be studying for AP Biology. Tip number 3 for at-home study tips is to remove all distractions. The easiest way to improve your focus is to limit the number of things that can potentially distract you. For example, study in a different room than where you leave your phone, or set a timer aside for 25 minutes of uninterrupted focus, followed by 5 minutes of uninterrupted breaks. This method, known as the Pomodoro technique, is a great way for you to get some focus time in for studying while also leaving enough time for your brain to recharge a little bit before resuming your studying. Before we jump into tip number 4, if you're finding this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. By doing so, you'll help other AP Biology students like yourself find this video. Tip 4 is to study with a buddy or with a group. One of the best ways to make sure that you're studying effectively for your AP Bio exam is to see whether or not you can explain a difficult concept to another person. When you're able to do so, it means that there's a higher probability that you've truly mastered that concept that you're being tested on. So it can be helpful to pair up with a friend of yours and work through concepts that each of you guys feel is difficult to one another. Through this collaboration, you can have a ton of productive AP Biology study sessions and improve both of your abilities to get a 4 or a 5. Our 5th general tip is to make sure that you feel comfortable with how to use your calculator when it comes to the AP Bio exam. You'll be able to use a 4-function scientific or graphing calculator, so it's really important that you are familiar and comfortable with how to use the calculator that you choose on test day. Now that we've covered 5 general AP Biology tips, let's jump into specifically what sort of tips we can keep in mind when we are approaching the multiple choice section for AP Biology. The first tip when it comes to crushing the multiple choice section is to make sure that you are pacing yourself well throughout the section. You're gonna have about 90 minutes to answer 60 multiple choice questions. This translates to about 90 seconds or a minute and a half for each question. So it's important for you to make sure that you are not spending way too much time on one question and not leaving enough time at the very end to answer every single question in the section. Build the habit of budgeting enough time to read the question twice to truly understand what's being asked of you, and then to work your way through a response. In the case where you're struggling to figure out which answer choice is best, circle that question and then come back to it later. It's far more beneficial for you to make sure that you're pacing well throughout the course of the multiple choice section than it is for you to get stuck up on one particular question. The second thing that can be helpful for you as you're preparing for the multiple choice section is to imagine the correct response. Once you've read the question once or twice and you understand what the question is trying to ask you, try to think about what the correct answer might look like before you actually read the answer choices. By doing so, you'll be able to prime your brain to look for the sorts of things that you thought was correct so that you can quickly identify the best possible answer choice. If you don't already use us, Albert can be a helpful resource for you when it comes to the AP Biology multiple choice section. The reason why is because we provide breakdowns of the correct and incorrect answer choices to help you better understand specifically why you got a particular answer right or wrong. Tip 3 is to carefully examine any visual materials that are provided to you. This means reviewing things like the labels, the axes, the titles, or anything that's been given to you in the graphical representation. On the AP Biology exam, you're going to be frequently asked to demonstrate your ability to interpret data in different formats. So it's really important for you to actually understand what is being presented to you and to not just guess because you only understand, for example, the axes, but not actually the data trends or representations that are being shown to you in the graph. Tip four when it comes to the multiple choice section is to be prepared to handle questions in sets. Sometimes you're going to have questions that are bundled together in sets of 2 to 4 questions. So you want to get into the habit of not necessarily getting too hung up on the fact that you might not have gotten the first question right in a set of 4, because you don't want that to impact your ability to get questions 2 through 4 correct in that set of questions. Typically speaking, each question will be able to be answered independently of one another, even if they are within a set of questions. And our last AP Bio multiple choice tip is to check your work. You want to leave at least 10 to 15 minutes at the end of your multiple choice section so that you can review any questions that were giving you difficulties the first time that you were checking them out. This is an ideal time for you to take a look at the questions you may have starred or circled so that you can give them an honest second look. Remember, when it comes to the multiple choice section, you don't get penalized for getting questions wrong. So every time you're trying your best at answering a multiple choice question correctly, you're increasing your odds of doing well on your AP Biology exam. Now, let's jump into some FRQ tips for AP Biology. Again, if you're finding this video helpful, you do us a great favor by hitting that like button below so that more students like yourself can find this video. Our first tip when it comes to tackling your free response section is to keep track of time. Ultimately, you're gonna have 90 minutes to answer 6 free response questions when it comes to AP Biology. 2 of these are going to be way longer than the other 4 questions, so it's important for you to block enough time to answer the 2 longer FRQs. We recommend that you block at least 20 minutes to answer each of the longer FRQs, because each of these longer FRQs are worth 10 points each. And then from there, block about 10 minutes for each of the remaining 4 questions. The reason why we do this is because these questions are typically only worth 4 points. By taking this sort of approach, you'll be able to have another 10 minutes at the very end that you can use towards a particular question that may have given you difficulty earlier in the free response section. Tip number 2 when it comes to the free response section is to make sure that you understand the scoring rubrics. The nice thing about the AP Biology exam is that the College Board actually gives you the roadmap as to how you can score a perfect score on the FRQs. All you need to do is refer to the course and exam description guides, as well as the chief reader reports, to better understand what sort of things students often do well in and where they struggle. By taking a look through chief reader reports or past released free response questions, you'll get a better understanding as to what the graders were looking for in order to score full points on that particular question. Then over time, you'll get to build a second sense as to what you need to make sure to include in your own responses in order to score those points as well. It's for this reason that we recommend you go through at least 3 years worth of previously released exams so you can better understand what the graders are looking for. Tip number 3 is to focus on the verbs when it comes to your free response questions. Regardless of what AP subject you're taking, the College Board uses a few core focus verbs that you're going to want to make sure you truly understand. To help you do that, we recommend that you circle or underline those focus verbs when you are reading them for the first time. Then make sure that you are actually crafting your response to answer what the verb is asking you to do. To give you a head start, here are a few of the commonly used focus verbs that the College Board likes to use. Calculate, construct, describe, determine, evaluate, support a claim, identify, and represent. If you're looking for a full list of the commonly used task verbs, check out the link to the accompanying blog post in the video description below. Tip 4 is to make sure that you are writing in complete sentences and paragraphs. In the instructions for the AP Biology free response section, it explicitly tells you that anything that is just bulleted is not going to be scored by the graders. In the FRQ instructions, it explicitly states that outlines, bulleted lists, and diagrams alone are not enough to be graded for the FRQs. This means that it's super important that you are always answering in complete sentences for both the longer questions as well as the short answer questions. Our 5th free response tip is to make sure that you are always doing these must-dos when it comes to tackling the free response questions. The first one is to make sure that you are answering the thing that is being asked of you. You do not need to restate the question, which is a mistake that students often make. The second thing you need to make sure you do is that you're answering every single part of the question. So aside from making sure you're answering the question, you also want to make sure that you're addressing every single point that is being asked of you. The third thing to make sure you do is if the question is asking you to do a calculation, you need to make sure you actually show your work. You can't just box a final answer and expect to get full points. The fourth thing you need to do is in the case where you have a table or a graph, you need to make sure you include everything that's necessary for the reader to understand what you are demonstrating to them. This means that your table or graph has a label, axes, points, as well as lines or curves that are relevant to the question that's being asked of you. A good way to think about this is if a person were to just read your graph without looking at the question or having any context behind it, does your graph make sense? If not, then you could probably work on that a little bit to make it more clear. The fifth thing you need to make sure you're doing is being succinct in your answers and always closing the loop. This is a common complaint from chief readers as to why they knocked points off from student responses. And the reason why is because students often focus so much on giving quantity of information, they're not focused on giving quality information in their responses. You want to make sure that you're not just brain dumping everything that you learned about a particular concept, but that you're applying it to the actual AP Biology free response question that's being asked of you. And the last thing you need to make sure you're always doing is using the structure of claim, evidence, and reasoning. Whenever you make a claim, you want to make sure you have evidence to support it and then explain your reasoning. There you have it, 15 tips to help you tackle your AP Biology exam. If you found this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. And if you're looking for more AP Biology or general AP review content, subscribe and hit that notification bell to get more content like this. If you haven't already created your free account on Albert to start practicing for your AP Biology exam, you can do so using the link in the video description below. With it, you're going to be able to try us out for a few topic areas and get immediate feedback to help you score that 4 or that 5. And in the case where you're an educator watching this video, if you want to try Albert out with your school, apply to pilot using the link in the video description below. With a pilot, you'll have access for a month to see how Albert works with you and your students. That's all for this time though. While you guys wait for the next video, check out these videos that YouTube thinks you might like.